Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Wild Man Creations. If this is your first time joining me, I'm Jay. And tonight we're going to be doing some smashed potatoes. And basically what I've got is these, they're smaller Yukon Golds is what I'm going to use. The recipe calls for 2 pounds. However, there's only two of us eating here. And even a pound is going to be way too much. But what I've done is I went ahead and mixed up my seasonings. They call for 1.5 teaspoons of garlic powder, 3/4 of a teaspoon of onion powder, a teaspoon of salt, and some black pepper. The black pepper, I would guess, probably 1/4 teaspoon. And I just mixed all that up because after I get done boiling these, then I'm going to put them on the cookie sheet and smash them, and then I'm going to dress them with the seasoning, and then I'm going to pop them in the oven. But what I've done is I've put them in here cold. I'm going to turn the water on, bring it up to a boil, and let them come to where they're fork tender, and then I'll bring you back, and we'll create the rest of the recipe. Oh, by the way, you want to preheat your oven to 425. So we'll get that going. I'll bring you back. Sit tight. Okay, so I boiled my potatoes, I drained them, I've let them cool here for about three or four minutes. That's what I'm looking for. It does not tell you to do this. Again, this is what I do. It tells you to spray a cookie sheet. I put foil down so I don't have to clean it, and I don't want to ruin my cookie sheet with the oils getting burnt. And it does not tell you to do this, but I'm doing it anyway. Why? Because I want a little bit of that seasoning underneath my potatoes. Are you only going to season one side of your steak? No. Are you only going to season one side of your hamburger? No. So why wouldn't you do that with your potatoes? Again, these are just a little past fork tender. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the bottom of a measuring cup. And you want to smash them down to where they're about, oh, I don't know, 1/4 inch, maybe a little bit less. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Okay. I'm going to drizzle them with a little olive oil. Very carefully. That's too much. Season. And it says put them in the oven for 25-35 minutes. I'm going to put them in for 25. We'll check them and see what they look like. I've got quite a bit of this left over, so if we want to put a little more seasoning on there, that's fine. Anyway, I'm going to put them in for 25 minutes and I'll bring you back. Sit tight. All right, here's our potatoes. You can see how they came out. Oh yeah. Nice and crispy on the bottom. Edges are crispy. And as you can probably already tell, this is, I got a bunch of stuff going here, so. This is gonna be, end up being part of another video. So anyway, that'll all come together here in a little bit. I did make some dill sauce earlier. And there's a video for that. And I will try, what I'm gonna try to do is I'm gonna try to bring all this together in one video and then, but make separate ones so that anybody that's interested can make one or the other. So if you guys will hang tight, we'll be back in just a minute. Sit tight. All right, so here we go with our pork chop with red wine, shallot sauce. Pretty good. And our smashed potato with dill sauce. I don't hear anything from the peanut gallery over there. What do you think?
I've only had the pork chop so far, but it's really good.
Man, that dill sauce and the potatoes are pretty good. It's different, but good. Anyway, thank you guys for spending your time with me. I appreciate it. If you would hit that subscribe button, hit the like button. And if you want to see any more videos, hit the notification bell. And share it with your friends, share it on social media, whatever. I need some more subscribers. Help me out. I appreciate y'all. Have a good evening. Bye.